Whether it's for your business, storage, or you're creating a tiny home, today we're inside this shipping container and we're gonna spray it with closed cell spray foam. So as you can see here in the shipping container, we don't have a lot of room in the actual wall cavity. That's what makes closed cell spray foam the best option. So what they're gonna do is they're gonna spray 2 inches of closed cell here. That's enough to create an air seal. They're gonna spray it into these cavities and behind these aluminum studs to help brace them a little bit more because they are kind of flimsy and they move a little bit. Closed cell is a perfect fit because it's very dense. And then when they're done spraying the walls, they'll be doing the ceiling as well with another 2 inches of closed cell. And like I said, 2 inches of closed cell is all they need to create an air seal in this shipping container. As you can see behind me, Casey's actually putting up plastic over these windows. He's already done the door in the back, and there's a window here and another glass door in the front that will also be covered with plastic. After those areas are covered, they're gonna go through and they're gonna put plastic on the floor. They do this to make sure that spray foam doesn't end up anywhere where they don't want it to be.
One thing that you may not expect when a crew comes out to spray foam or inject your home is going to be the sound, because they have to run generators and there's hoses running and everything. It is very loud, but the good news is that they work like a well-oiled machine. These crews are going to come out and work hard and fast to make sure that the disruption to the homeowner's life is at a minimum.
As you can see behind me, Casey's process for spraying the closed cell spray foam is very precise. First, he's spraying behind those aluminum studs to make sure to fill in that gap. Then he's gonna go back through and he's gonna fill those wall cavities to make sure that there's a complete air seal.
The technique that Casey's using as he sprays the closed cell spray foam ensures that it's gonna have a nice smooth finish and looks a lot better than if he just kind of haphazardly was spraying inside of those cavities.
So I just want to take a moment to talk about why closed cell spray foam is such a great option for this project. Closed cell spray foam doesn't have the same expansion rate that open cell does. In these small cavities, closed cell is the best option because it's not going to expand. You're not going to have a ton of cutback for it, and you're not going to have any wasted product. It's the perfect option for these kind of shallow walls. As a part of the cleanup process, one of the crew members is going through and he's gonna scrape off all of that excess closed cell foam from the studs. Now, this is gonna leave a little bit of a mess as there's gonna be piles of foam on the ground, but this crew is meticulous. They're gonna go through, they're gonna clean up that loose foam, they're gonna clean up all of the plastic that they laid down and put over the windows to protect everything. And when they leave, everything's gonna look nice, clean, and pristine. And here you can see the finished product. If this looks like something that'd be a great addition for your project, check out our Find a Dealer page where you can find a RetroFoam dealer who may also offer spray foam. I'm your building science brainiac, reminding you to put a little science in every project.